Hey guys, I don't even know why my eyes, is it my eyes or does this just look so foggy? I think it's my eyes, you know. I've been crying, but I don't know, like, nah, it look foggy for real. Does it, guys? I feel like I'm paranoid. Anyways, foggy or not.
Come on!
So I just had this I had this idea because it's Black History Month. I've been listening to a lot of Sam Cooke for the past couple months, and I'm just falling in love with him, his music. And I remember a story. I was listening. There's a particular song I want to do a TikTok to. It's called "Twisting the Night Away," and it's literally like, because I literally just be to work and then be in my headphones and I like animated, like, just I sing in it as I do my work, put my papers over, like, it really just gets me going. So I'm just like, ah, I want to do a video to this, like, I want to be dancing, I want to twist. And so I went online and I was like watching people actually do the dance, because I don't know how to do the dance. So I was like, we got to do some research. If we're going to do a TikTok, you know, it's going to go out there. Wow, I sound like an old person, but yeah. So I'm watching the videos and as I scroll, like, it's just white people doing a twist, right? And I'm just like, and like as I'm watching this dance, I just start to feel so heavy and just start crying. And then I watch this video of him performing it, and he was performing it normal, like, it wasn't no, like, it didn't seem, you know, like when Michael Jackson performed, it's like he in it, like you could see it all in his face and stuff like that. It just seemed like he was singing a song, like he was on a mic and he was just singing a song. And I was just like, I wonder what he was really thinking then, like if he was even into it, because it was a white crowd obviously. And I was just like, wow, but like the things that we, I don't know, I just feel like I overthink things so much, but, and I always get so heavy. But like just thinking about him singing and dancing and like providing entertainment for people that he knew hated his freaking guts, like hated the ground he walked on, hated the air he breathed, like I just thought that was so freaking crazy. And I'm just like, bruh, being Black is, it's just so much. But to think that, I was just also thinking, because I'm trying not to be so deep, but I just thought I would record it because this is how I feel right now, and I thought it was worth recording. If I ever do the TikTok and I put it out there and people watch it, I want to know, I want this process to also be a part of it, because it is Black History Month and we feel these things and we think about these things every day. But because I think about them killing so much people for no reason. Anyways, oh God, wow. Anyways, what I was also thinking was if, like, Black artists back then, you know, like, where there was segregation and all of those stuff and Jim Crow laws, like, if they would obviously perform at these segregated shows or at all-white shows and then go home and have fun, or, like, you know, like, when you're around your friends and your family and stuff like that, you have a lot more fun doing things that you like. So obviously if you're an artist and you like to sing, like, do you sing those songs and do you have a party with your family and friends and stuff like that? I always wondered if they did that, like, they had their own, like, you know, safe spaces, kind of like if you watch, oh my God, Queen and Slim. If you watch Queen and Slim, and like when it was on the run, and they was driving and they stopped at this bar, it was an all Black bar, and obviously everybody was on the lookout for them, and people was racist, but they just knew they were safe there and they had a good time. And I just always, I think about if there were safe spaces, obviously there were safe spaces like that, but I guess when I think about the extreme end of, like, people literally just hating your guts because you exist, I try to think about spaces where you get to be yourself and where you're appreciated for being who you are and for being Black, and you feel like you're there. and you're, you know, you're seen. And so in seeing him perform in front of all those white people, and it didn't seem like he was really into it, I don't know, I don't even know if he was into it or not. I also was trying to think, like, well, maybe after this show he went back and he was with his friends and he was having a good time, or like, you know, like those little stuff. But anyways, if you see the TikTok, if I do record it, do the twist, okay? Because obviously we all love his music and we all love black culture. Everybody loves black culture, everybody likes to steal it, but I like to like white out the parts that kind of made, like the parts that kind of made us who we are, the resilient, hardworking, ingenuitive, like so amazing people that we are. Like it's not from lack of struggle, it's not from lack of hate, it's not from lack of constant no's and constant obstacles and constant no, you can't go through here, no, you don't belong here, no, you don't exist. It's like literally, like, you know, your fist squeezed, like you trying to force water through that, or like not water because water is water, but like you trying to force an object through hair. Like that's literally how black people exist, and the fact that things be coming on the other side, that's crazy. So I don't know, I think duality and just knowing that things could be multiple things could be true at once, and just taking in the whole story, the full thing, the full feeling. And yeah, but sometimes I try to like let go and actually just enjoy the fun, and that was what I want, that's what I want to do if I do record the video of me doing the twist, because we should enjoy those moments too. Like, and the fact that there are only black, I mean white people, maybe there are some black people doing a twist on YouTube, but it ain't at the top, which is crazy. But let me go and actually look, because all I seen is these white girls twisting the night away, Sam Cooke original, like literally just white faces, and fucking R. Kelly vomits. Is this a black? Nope, those are white people. Okay, there's a band in Carolina playing it, but nobody's dancing to it. Wait, what's this? 14 years ago? YouTube was around 14 years ago? Okay, these people are black, but it's so fuzzy. You can't even see it. She's moving up and back. Twisting the night away. Twisting, twisting. Everybody's feeling great. We're twisting, twisting, twisting the night. Okay, but yeah, I see one. Okay, another thing. This looks like Soul Train, but there are some black people in the back. I mean, white people in the back there. I don't know, man. I don't know. Too many white faces for a black man song. I'm sorry, but yeah. So I'm gonna do the TikTok. I'm gonna try. I just thought I'd share this. I don't even know if I'll post this. Happy Black History Month, and you are loved, you are seen, and you belong here. Like honestly, even when people make you feel like you don't. Hey guys, so this is editing me, and no, I never did the TikTok simply because I just never really got the twist down to what I thought would be TikTok worthy. So this is a video of me attempting to do the twist but also failing, because this is like one of like my third attempts or so. But I also wanted to add on to this video, so to cover up all the copyright music, but I wanted to add that oftentimes, like during Black History Month, we think about
and we remember and acknowledge all the people that have been noted in history or that may have done things that we think are so exceptional. And we often forget the Black people in our lives, or we even forget that we are Black people making Black history every day. And I just wanted to point out that you don't have to look so far beyond your own circle to celebrate Black history. Like, you can look at your grandparents, your great grandparents, and if you don't know their stories, you can ask, because a lot of the stories that you see in the news, that's somebody's grandparent, like, they asked about this, that story, or maybe, yeah, obviously somebody else told it, but there's so much more. A lot of times when I'm feeling connected, or even just want to think about, like, when I think about Black excellence and Black people persevering, I think about my grandmother, and she's a cook, and she, in my opinion, I think she's successful, and I just think about that, like, if she could make it through cooking for all these white people and taking care of them and taking care of their children and cleaning up behind them and just, you know, still being successful, still being so loving, so caring, so uncallous, like, she's the least callous person I know, I could do it too. And so I don't look to Martin Luther King or Malcolm X. Yes, those are great inspirations, or not even Barack Obama, but like I say, I try to look, like, nearsighted. I try to look in my sphere at my mother, because as much as, okay, yeah, slavery was so long ago, allegedly, according to white people, Black people are still making strides and making history every day, because it really wasn't that long ago. And so the successes of me, my family, and my friends, I think we're all making Black history, and I like to think about those things, even myself, like the things that I overcome and the things that I'm able to do now is because my mom and my grandmother would have had to make certain sacrifices, would have had to take certain jobs, would have had to put up with certain people foolishness just to make sure that I'm in a position where I could do what I'm doing now, and I don't have to do that, or I have the privilege to maybe choose to opt out of those rules, or, you know, like, basically, I guess y'all get what I'm trying to say. Anyways, happy Black History Month again, and don't forget that you exist, you're appreciated, you belong here, and you're making Black history just as much as those other people. Yeah.